Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Scarlet Void. Welcome to Exodus Season 3 Genesis. This is Episode 2. Who and we're about to try killing Red. Or those
who. So, what's the target, producer?
We're heading to the theater and taking out the host.
It's about time. That monster deserves what's coming to him. I don't know if you know this, but he killed my family. He came into my home and killed them while I was stuck on that awful space station. He tormented my daughter before he killed her. I heard it on a recording.
I'm sorry.
I'm the reason they died. If I had just died like I was supposed to on Venera or on that station, they would still be alive. The host is afraid of me. He killed them because I've survived everything he's thrown at me. Today we will avenge my family, producer. We will deliver justice.
Let's do this.
Come, get in the gunship. It's time to kill a host.
I imagine some of you guys want to see him die. Well, we'll see. We'll see.
The theater is west a few blocks. It's hard to miss. Here is your ticket. Use it to get in. I will relay further instructions once you are seated.
Let's see. That's where my frame rates keep on getting the hell of a hit whenever I am. In this city. What's causing all the lag? I have no clue. Maybe it's the textures, the models? Not sure. If the frame rate starts dropping below a certain point, expect me to reload the map when that happens. If I'm missing one of the tires or not. It feels like I am, but I don't know. I'll be moving over to this for a second to see what's up there. I haven't really explored this yet, so. Let's see if there's anything worthwhile on the top of this. Or whether, unfortunately, they didn't think of the fact that they may actually want to explore this. It's unlikely, but, well, there's still a slight, extremely slight probability that they didn't think of it, but they probably did, so there might be something interesting up here. Actually, it's probably collectible when I think about it. And speaking of which, I'm guessing. Yeah. I'll be collecting. I'm taking Ivern's head. What do you think? Yeah, blue doesn't suit me either. Now let's get this sorted. Red has a bit of a problem coming his way. Let's just make damn sure that This is very unpleasant for him. Well, I guess I'll see.
Welcome to Capital City Radio. I'm your host, Kevin. Here today, tomorrow, and for the end of time. This morning, I'm joined with our very own president. Welcome, Madam President, to the show.
It's a pleasure to be here. Now, you're going to be a good boy this time and follow the script, right, Kevin?
You realize you're recording, right?
Of course I realize we're recording. That's what the red light's for.
Is that Chardonnay, Madam President?
No, it's Merlot, you uncultured swine. And what concern is that to you?
Pardon me, I just haven't seen alcohol in 10 years. Anyway, let's get to the questions. As you know, our planet is experiencing some unfortunate climate situations. What efforts are we taking to make the world more habitable?
Well, we are working tirelessly to heal the world, I tell you that. We are planning to initiate several restoration projects within the next few years.
But, Madam President, humanity will be almost extinct by then. What programs do we have implemented to help heal our planet now?
We have many programs. We have the best programs out there, Kevin. I promise you that.
Could you explain what these programs entail?
You know, Kevin, I don't appreciate your tone. Let's move on to the next question.
Okay, fine. Just don't shoot my bobblehead. So earlier today, there was another Phoenix attack. The bridge just east of the city was destroyed, and reports suggested upwards of 30 civilians and military personnel were killed during the attack. What is the government response to these terrorist attacks?
A terrible attack that was. The Phoenix Division is a radical terrorist organization that's trying to turn our citizens against the government. We must stand together against this threat. We are currently trying to locate their safe houses and destroy them. My condolences go to all those affected by today's attack.
I'm sure they appreciate the sentiment. One last question. There's been rumors that you've been allocating resources to... Sorry, wrong question. Please don't hurt my bobblehead.
Go to the last question, Kevin.
Of course, Madam President. Tonight, Exodus reviews its third season. Are you excited for it?
Of course I'm excited, Kevin. If there's one thing the public knows about me, it's that Exodus is my favorite show ever made. I can't wait to see where it takes our newest contestants.
I think everyone just loves Exodus, especially since it's the only TV show that's airing. Remember to tune in tonight at Exodus Season 3, Genesis. It's said to be a massive adventure in a jungle inhabited by deadly beasts. Will our newest contestants survive? Find out tonight. Well, that's another product placement for me. You just shot the intern!
I was aiming for the bobblehead.
Oh, well, at least the bobblehead's safe. So, can we say that your aim is like your politics? Misdirected?
Move on, Kevin.
Okay. Sorry. Let's just cut to the end. It's been a pleasure being here.
It's been a pleasure being here, Kevin.
Alright, that's it for me. We'll be right back on Capital City Radio, but first we have to clean up the intern's dead body.
I'll be sure to tell your supervisor that you didn't go by the script, and next time I'll shoot the bobblehead. Hey! It's still recording! Turn that off!
Well, that was interesting. I have a feeling that I probably will be enjoying ending her, given the opportunity. Let's see, okay, I didn't actually notice before that people have to wear gas masks. I probably should have looked at the characters a bit more depthly than I did last time. See, they blockaded this section.
Want an apple? I've got lots of rotting apples.
No, thank you.
I got the good stuff. Lots of good stuff.
I literally see nothing.
Please, my family is sick. Please, I'll take anything.
Sorry, we're out of water, but we'll have more tomorrow.
I'm taking this. Let's see, no. There has to be alleyway somewhere, how did I forget the...
Watch as it is tonight! Monsters await contestants in the jungle! Season 3 premieres tonight! Be sure to watch it!
Just one!
I don't have a feeling he's getting paid for that. Actually, for some reason it reminds me of the Paperboy thing that existed. What was it? Goddamn, I can't remember. I think it was from the 60s all the way up to the early 90s, maybe? I'm not sure. But, yeah, sort of reminds me of those boys who would go around on advertising the news and
please,
try selling it.
My family is sick. Please.
Let's see, where the hell? Maybe right there. Maybe I'm meant to go through there. Nope. Caged.
Please. My family is sick.
This might be a bit of a lengthier episode than I intended. Maybe let's go back and see that little outpost thing that the soldiers set up. Maybe there, from there I could see where I could go.
Exodus Season 3 premieres tonight! You better watch or the government will arrest you and imprison you! Watch it tonight! See
no
all the contestants
business.
Eaten by monsters in the jungle!
Let's see, I'm borrowing this sword.
Move along.
Okay.
Exodus Season 3 premieres tonight! You better watch!
I swear there is... has to be somewhere. God damn it. Okay, let's just start sprinting to get through this much quicker.
Exodus Season 3 premieres tonight!
No.
There's some water.
Sure, yeah. Here it is.
Please, my family is sick. Please,
nope,
I'll take anything.
See.
Why is there so much pain?
These people, they're suffering.
True.
Hello, do you like my new boots? They sparkle.
Aw, how cute. Where'd you get them?
I stole them. Daddy's gonna be so proud of me.
Let's see. Okay, here it is. I'm so curious why these buildings were designed like this. Let's hide you over here. This may be a little bit safer for you. Come on. Hide. You stole those. The last thing you need is the owner to find you.
People come up to me and ask, Senator Warlock, why are 85% of the light bulbs out? I say to them, it's because 99% of the power goes to 1% of the people. We need to distribute this power among the 99%. We need to literally break up the 1% and distribute their limbs to the common people. This we must do.
But aren't you part of the 1%? You're a senator.
This person is right. I am part of the 1%, but it's not what you think. See, I am a warlock, and 99% of us are not. In fact, I'm a level 24 warlock, which doesn't sound that good until you realize there's only 25 levels. It sounds really good. But if I'm elected president, everyone will become warlocks.
Can we not save these people?
Time grows short for all of us.
52%, 63%, 12%, 94%, 26%.
Aren't you just saying percentages?
Okay.
Just one credit, please.
Center warlock just makes me cringe like big no tomorrow. Okay, let's get away from that very, very questionable person. And...
Spare
some water. Okay. I swear, why do I keep on seeing similarities is to historical structures? To me, for some reason, it makes me think of where Nazis entering World War II assembled the troops. It was where Hitler intended to give his speeches to them.
Ticket, please.
Here's the ticket.
Thank you. Enjoy the show.
We'll see about that. Oh god, not again. Not again. Why do you freaking freeze every cursed time I'm here? Oh crap. Yeah, one hell of a lag spike. F3 plus A. Does this help? Somewhat. Soldiers on guard. This is why my frame rate gets its ass.
Welcome, everyone. As you know, our world is a dark place, full of misery, suffering, and death. But out of the darkness comes a light that gives us hope. And it comes in the form of this show. Exodus is the gateway to a better world. I'm not saying this to gain viewers, but simply because it's true. Over the past 4 years, I have worked closely with the government on a project that will transform our home. Tonight, the public will lay eyes upon it for the first time. Exodus Season 3, Genesis. Thank you. It feels great to finally reach this point, the point that all the sacrifices we've made were not in vain. After the attacks on the Temerity last year, nearly 200 died trying to make Exodus a reality. Among them was my sister-in-law, Captain Hollis Monroe. Years ago, when my own sister died, I was there for Hollis, and she was there for me. My sister's death shook us both to our very core, and now that Hollis is also gone, I must now continue what they believed in. A world that can be healthy and green again. In remembrance of the crew and our beloved captain, I have asked her younger brother, Lieutenant Ryan Monroe, to join us today. Ryan?
Thank you, sir. My sister served our great country with all of her being. She believed that one day the world could be healed, to be brought back to the days when grass still grew and animals still roamed the hills, before the sky was dark and menacing, looming over us, counting down the years to our extinction. Those years have turned to months, weeks, and now days. If we don't do something, humanity will be dead within the next 5 years. That's why my sister became the captain of the Temerity. She hoped to one day lead us out of the darkness of this world and into the light of another. Thanks to Exodus, we still have that chance. She told me herself that she was skeptical, that a TV show could save the world. I was too. But no longer. I've seen the power of Genesis, and it is scary, but it is also good. My sister and crew died to bring us Genesis, and I assure you, their sacrifice was not in vain. Tonight, you will see. Now, if you will please, join me in a moment of silence for those we have lost.
All right, it's time. Find a way backstage and plant the bombs in the designated locations. Try not to draw attention to yourself.
Why am I always the one stuck doing the dirty work? Let's see. Unfortunately, this section is the section I despise with my heart and soul. Not so much for story reasons. The story is absolutely great so far. It's freaking parkour by Nemesis. Something I despise with a damn passion a long time.
Thank you, Mr. Monroe. Now, before we show you Genesis, we must take you back in time. Almost 400 years ago, humanity began to make irreparable damage to our world when the Industrial Revolution began. Our ancestors began to thrive at the expense of the world they called home. It wasn't until about a century ago that people really began to notice that the Earth was becoming sick. No one listened to them until resources began to dwindle in 2050. That's when the Great War began. The war that tore us apart. However, in the end, we all joined together to form a government called the Union. And we had peace. Until we realized that even with our own conservation efforts, we could not heal our world quickly enough. For the Great War had poisoned the very ground we stand on. Ever since then, the majority of humanity has lost hope. It has led to rebellions such as the Federation and now the Phoenix Division. But there is still hope, and Exodus Season 3 will bring hope back to every single one of us! Today is a new beginning for all mankind! Welcome to Genesis! Now, without further ado, I present the profiles of the contestants for Exodus Season 3.
Good job. Look for a prop crate. You should find some explosives hidden there. Plant them beneath the stage. When detonated, they should kill anyone on the stage above.
There we go. Place it back here. And start shooting. I have technician taken? Nope. Let's see. Another one of these. I know, well, I missed plenty of them. Yeah, no. As long as these rags are still intact, I'm going to be keeping them on. Fake one. Explosive. Bread. You can never have too much bread. And more purified water. Raw meat. Let's see there. Nope. Taking. Ada. Come on. I'm pretty sure there's more than one bomb. Guess I'm wrong. I wish this script thing actually had more information than just that. But again, nitpicks. That. And this is last one. And yeah, I guess only one bomb.
Planting more bombs, I see.
Yes.
Boom, boom.
All right, now head back to your seat. I'll tell you when to detonate the bombs.
I know well enough you will enjoy. You enjoy explosives, Ivren. Like I imagine you enjoyed blowing up our ship. Well, to be fair, he was doing that in hopes of defending.
Stop. This is the safest place in the theater to detonate the bombs. The host is currently on stage presenting a slideshow. It's time.
No, I can't do it. What if he can save the world?
What? The host is a sociopath. We know he has the broadcast weapon from the Dendron. That's what Genesis is. He's going to enslave the world. He's going to take our freedom away and force us to work on a fool's errand. The world cannot be saved. Press the button, producer.
What are you waiting for? Do it!
We don't know that. There's still a chance the world can be saved.
How could you be agreeing with that monster? He killed everyone on the Temerity aside from you and me. He killed my family! Detonate it now. This is your final chance to please the will of the Phoenix.
You're making her very angry. Not very advisable.
Sorry, but I do not like this. Particularly due to the fact that a certain one's brother's there.
No, even though he did those things, he's still the best hope humanity has.
So be it. Activate the backup.
What? No!
Phoenix is not smiling, producer, but she shows forgiveness. Union soldiers will be looking for the bomber. If you can make it to our safe house across the street from the theater in Mary's Bakery, perhaps you can be given a second chance. Either way, your odds for survival are much better with us than with the government.
I have to question that. Seriously, you've been making me bomb on these targets. Military target is one thing. Civilian... it's another.
Spare some water. Please, my family is sick.
Okay. Let's get out of here quickly.
No funny business.
No, I don't have any water. Move along.
Just one thing.
Shine upon you.
Taking.
Others must be enlightened.
You made it. Good for you. We'll wait here until there's a break in their search grid, then we'll head back to the monastery.
Once again, the Phoenix has attacked our city. All in an attempt to stop us from trying to save the world. If they think a single bomb will stop us, then we don't have a thing to worry about. But in all seriousness, I just want to say hi to an old friend of mine who has joined me. I know the bomb was meant for me, but instead your handiwork has killed one of my most loyal soldiers, Lieutenant Ryan Monroe. Will be missed. But like his sister, his death will not be in vain. Watch your back, old friend. An acquaintance of ours will be paying you a visit real soon.
Yeah, and I'm the one that refused to pull the damned trigger to that bomb. Ubenhire, I do not need you in the damned slightest. See, that man had nothing, and I mean nothing, to do with this. All he was doing was his job, and that's it.
The light grows fainter with every passing moment. Every day, people become sick and are starving in the streets! Death count is rising swiftly. They are suffering a fate that is worse than death itself, yet they still cling to the hope that they can survive. We must enlighten them. Show them that there is nothing left in this life aside from pain and loss. It is time for humanity to be reborn. To begin again in a new world where there is peace and happiness. Tonight, we will enlighten the world and show them the wisdom of the Phoenix. And together, we will rise from the ashes. Rise!
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 But first, we must welcome the producer back. They have returned from a mission to free us from the demon. Were you successful, producer?
No. The host still lives.
Because you don't believe in the Phoenix, do you, producer? You believe the world still has a chance, don't you?
You're fanatics. You're worse than the government.
Don't you dare compare us to the Union! They stand there and watch us die without a care. Their so-called plan to save the world will enslave us, and we will all die anyway fighting for something that is impossible. Humanity is extinct. It's time people woke up and took this as fact. Seize the non-believer and throw him in a cell. He'll burn in the glow of the Phoenix tonight.
Yeah. If you think... that's going to make me... change my mind about what you guys... No. Not even close. Not even remotely.
It's not too late, producer. You can come back to us. Paul is just overreacting.
You all are. You want to kill everyone.
We're not going to kill everyone. We are freeing them from the painful sickness that will wipe us out anyway.
When I first joined the Phoenix, I was skeptical too. I thought their goals were insane and evil. But then I remembered what the government had done. They killed my family. Red tormented my daughter before she died. Those who are supposed to be saving us are not the people who should be. They are monsters. We are all monsters.
Unfortunately, this is something that seems to be oddly true. But, eenie, meenie, miney, moe, can you talk about stuff? How does it go, eenie, meenie, miney, moe? Screw it, this probably is more likely to get to her.
Just because the government is evil doesn't mean we have to kill everyone.
No, but it's the only way. If the government succeeds tonight, they will control the minds of everyone in the world with that broadcast weapon they stole last year. Not many people realize that Genesis is actually a mind control weapon. Citizens wouldn't believe us even if we told them. No. If we fail tonight, the host will work us to death trying to save a planet that can't be saved. Genocide is a much kinder fate.
How are you planning to kill everyone?
You'll have to wait till tonight. But it will be far less painful than what the government has planned. That much I know.
Sure, sure.
No. They found us. The government is here. I'll unlock your cell door. Get to the hangar if you want to live. I doubt the Union is taking prisoners.
Speaking of which, gunfire. Well, let's see. Wait, still doors open. The monster is currently in flames. This seems like a good day, and a good place to end this episode off. Sorry about me not being all that talkative. There really wasn't really much for me to talk about in this case, and plus, much, much voice acting is occurring. Hopefully in the next episode I will have a little bit more to say. So yeah, this has been the Scarlet Void. Been good recording for you guys. And I look forward to next time. Bye.